Dear students, today we will discuss about algorithm nature, abstract nature of algorithms. So the algorithms are basically abstract, and then there are representations to represent that algorithm in certain form that is kind of particular, focused and typical. So we say that if you make an analogy with story and a book. So you read a storybook, each book is following a story. That story is kind of abstraction. And the physical book which has been written by one author is basically the representation of that story. Similarly, you can say that the story of a movie or story of a cartoon or story of a film could be abstract, and then that story is basically executed in the form of actual dialogues, in the form of actual writing, in the form of actual book, actual script, actual dialogue. That kind of thing is called the representation. So the algorithm is basically an abstract thing, and then its representation could be different. And in computer science, we try to make the representation in a way that is understood, understandable by all of the users. So how we will be doing it, we will be learning in some of the next modules. Similarly, the translation of a book to another language is also called its representation. So in terms of algorithm, for example, if I want to convert Fahrenheit to Celsius to Fahrenheit, so we want to convert the temperature that is present at the moment in Celsius into the Fahrenheit. So one of the way of representing this algorithm is this one. So this is one of the way. What you said, F is equal to 9/5 C + 32. And I have understood, and you have also understood that what I mean. There could be another way of telling the same algorithm. The representation could be different, which is here, that second number. We are saying multiply the temperature reading in Celsius by 9/5 and then add 32 to the product you have acquired. So this is another way of telling this thing. Or there could be another way, the third way, which is a form of an electronic circuit which converts Celsius into Fahrenheit. So sometime it becomes confusing. So materiologists could understand what you have written, that convert the Celsius reading to Fahrenheit equivalent. So they know what we mean, because this is their daily life operation, and they know the equation that how to convert Celsius into Fahrenheit. However, lay person can argue it's ambiguous, that I do not know how to convert Celsius into Fahrenheit. So to overcome this problem, we will come up with a concept of primitives that will solve this thing in the next module. So we will define certain primitives which will be symbols. They have symbols, and those symbols would have some certain definite meaning, and those meaning are universally understandable by all of the community. And here we should also differentiate between program and process. So formal representation of an algorithm is called the program, which is written normally in a programming language. And executing a program is called process, which we have learned in one of the computer architecture modules previously. So this means the executing of an algorithm is also called the process, right? So we summarize today's module. We have learned about algorithm, that is an abstract thing, and it's possible different representations, And then we learned that those representations could be ambiguous for different people. And then we converged our discussion that we need some primitive concepts. Those are understandable by everyone, that what is the symbol and what is its meaning, which we will start discussing in the next module.